other little things like that that make you want to put yourself away from society. And he was prescribed opioids after, I think it was a root canal or some other dental problem that he went to, and they prescribed him Oxycontin, and he became addicted to it and lost everything in his life. Everything went downhill. He became homeless, and his parents found out about it. They tried to help him over and over again. They did everything they could to try and help him, but because he was addicted, he just kept relapsing and kept going back to it. And it, because it's a medical problem and a mental problem, which is, they're kind of the same but kind of different, because a medical problem can be looked at by a doctor and fixed, and I mean, it can be fixed on plain sight, but a medical problem can much more easily come back, and when it's your mental health, it's much harder to see that you're okay. And because of that, parents and anyone around him can't tell that he's going to relapse and go back to those tendencies and continue to abuse drugs. And I think that's one of the problems with saying that parents are the ones that need to be in charge of this and need to be the ones that are responsible for their kids, is that no matter what a parent does, there's so many things that can go wrong and so many things that can happen to make you go back to those drugs if you use them before or go to those drugs. Because
he was really speaking to you so clearly, he saw his way through that addiction, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So how did he do that, and then what did you learn from that?
Well, what happened is he got to the very bottom, rock bottom. He was stealing, he was living under a bridge, he was homeless for months. And after a while, either his parents or someone invited him to come up to a facility in Cincinnati that helped him overcome his addiction and become sober again. But after that, he relapsed again. And he ended up going to the Salvation Army, and they helped him get clean again, and he slowly started to build up, and then it happened again, and by the third time he was finally able to get out of it. And he said it's just always a constant struggle and always a mental health battle to stay away from addiction and continue to live a normal life, because there's always that piece of them that wants to go back and wants to use those drugs again because they feel good and he wants to feel good.
It sounded like he got treatment, but then he had some support services.
Yeah.
And sort of
in friends and family, his church especially, a lot. And it takes a lot to help these people, but it's something that they have to constantly fight through their entire lives. I think the main thing we need to focus on is preventing it in the first place. And because once it happens and once you become addicted, there's almost no going back. There's a little bit of hope that you can turn around like he did, and then even then you still have to fight constantly to keep yourself away from those temptations.
When you have an addiction, there is a 5-year period which you're still 100% vulnerable to a relapse. After you've gone clean, you have to wait 5 years before you become a significantly lower risk factor of going back to that drug.
It's a lifelong relapsing chronic brain disease.
Yes.
Right.
That's why it's complicated.
It's not just a medical problem. It's
it's
a mental health problem, and it affects everyone and everything around you.
So it's a big issue. I'm glad you guys are doing some research on it. I guess my question is, what will you do to make a difference? Now that you've learned all this,
has it
made you want to make a difference? And what might you be able to do to make a difference with it?
Personally, it makes me think that I need to influence people and try and create an influence to help create legislation that changes how these drugs are prescribed and changes how they get into the country and stops them from reaching the people that they reach and stops them from creating such a problem in our society, because it's a huge problem. And I think it was the CDC, they estimated the yearly cost for the opioid epidemic, including medical cost, societal cost, court cost, all the increased costs associated with opioids and the people that are abusing them and the problems they run into. And it was, I think, $70 billion each year. That's a huge problem. That's like cancer, the medication that people have to buy for it, that's a total of $100 billion. So that's bordering on the same amount that costs cancer. And this is something that we have a lot more control over, and we have an ability to stop. And I mean, cancer, you get cancer, and you have to try and stop it. But opioids, we have a chance to stop it before it reaches people, before it affects people, and before it creates these huge costs and problems and everything that it causes.
Me, I'm gonna plan on going to BMI and joining the military, and then hopefully I'll be able to fight the people who are bringing them into the country. So from the outside, that's what it is.